Today we are going to see about UPS topology, calculations for energy consumptions and battery backup. First we are going to see about UPS topologies. The first type is standby, the next one is a line interactive and a double conversion online. So we are presently having three types of UPS topologies. We will see one by one. In standby UPS topology, this is the most basic UPS topology which is being used nowadays. It restores to battery power in the event of common power problems. So, the power problems represents blackouts, voltage sag and voltage swell. Here the blackout represents the complete interruption of power. Voltage sag represent low voltage and voltage swell represent high voltages. So the standby UPS will address these three problems. So when there is a blackout, the UPS will providing you the power. When there is a sag that represent low voltage, the UPS will give you the correct power required. As well as in the swell which represents high voltage, the UPS will deliver you the required power and voltage to the device which you are connected. When the incoming power drops or swells to the safe voltage level, the UPS switches to DC battery power. So once the voltage, that is the input voltage, is fluctuating in nature, then the UPS will switches to the DC battery power which is present in the UPS itself. The next one is the line interactive UPS. In line interactive UPS incorporates technology which allows it to convert minor power fluctuations without switching to battery power. So in the previous case, the UPS will convert from AC to DC and it will switches the power. When the AC voltage is having a low voltage or a power fluctuation, at once it will uses its battery power to supply the required device. But in case of line interactive UPS, this type of UPS, when there is a minor problem such as a sag or swell, that is a low voltage or higher voltage, this UPS will correct the line voltage, that is the AC power which is given in as a input to the UPS, which will correct to the required level and it will deliver to the output device. This type of inverter has an auto transformer that regulates low voltage and over voltage. So these interactive UPS will have an auto transformer in it. If there is a low voltage, the auto transformer will be in the step up mode so that it will deliver the correct voltage to the device which you are connected. When there is a high voltage, then the auto transformer will be connected in a step down transformer mode so that the correct voltage will be provided to the device which you are connected to the other end of the UPS. The last type of UPS is double conversion online UPS. UPS provide consistent, clean and near perfect power regardless of the condition of incoming AC supply. So these types of UPS are being preferred nowadays because these types of UPS will provide you a very clean and perfect output power irrespective of the AC power which is being delivered into the UPS. This types of UPS converts AC supply to DC supply and then it will convert the DC supply back to AC supply. So you know that the input power which is fed into the UPS is a AC supply. At once the UPS will convert the input AC supply into a clean DC supply. After convert this into DC supply, this DC supply is again converted back into AC supply with the help of a inverter which is present in the UPS. So the AC supply which is being converted from the DC supply will have a very clean output and will have a perfect efficiency and it will have a perfect regulation, so that the voltage level and the frequency will be maintained as a constant. So it is mentioned as a clean power or a perfect power. These types of UPS operates on isolated DC power. So these types of UPS are being used whenever you need to have a machine which is to be isolated and it should be worked for several days without interruption. These types of UPS can be used. These types of UPS will have also a battery unit. When there is a power loss, when there is a complete interruption of power in the AC side, at once the UPS will switches to the battery power and it will run the device which you have connected. Next, we will be seeing about the UPS output waveforms. So the basic output waveform which the power frequency is sine wave output, which will be like this, okay. And the other one is the simulated sine wave output. So here you can see this blue line. This blue line is known as the simulated sine wave output. So most of the older UPS will give you this blue line, that is the simulated sine wave output. But in case of modern UPS, you will be getting a perfect sine wave like the power frequency. So this simulated sine wave will produce harmonics and this will produce a humming in the fan or tube lights which are being connected to the olden types of inverters. But in nowadays we are using sine wave output inverters, so there will be no such noises can be heard. Battery backup. Today we are seeing about the some calculations regarding the battery capacity and the inverter capacity and the total amount of backup time that a inverter can withstand. So most of the battery connected to the UPS will have a voltage rating of 12 volt. So the capacity of battery is equal to power load in watts into battery backup in hours divided by voltage of the battery. So let us see a very small example. Consider a power load of 500 watts need to turn for 4 hours, then calculate battery capacity. So you are going to turn on a 500 watts load for 4 hours, then what is the capacity of the battery you need to be used in the inverter? So you can easily calculate with the help of the formula. Capacity of battery is equal to 500 watts, and the total number of time the battery that the load is to be on is 4 hours. So the battery voltage is nothing but 12 volt. So you will get the battery capacity as 166.67 ampere hour. Next, we will be seeing about the capacity of the inverters. So the inverter capacities, there are different capacities of inverters available for domestic appliances. They are 200 volt amperes, 250 volt ampere, 350 volt ampere, 400 volt ampere, and up to 1200 volt amperes, and so on. Okay, you can purchase your required capacity of inverter as you need it. So in a small house, you can purchase a 500 volt ampere inverter. If you are having a lot of load such as fan or lights, you need to go for a higher range, say 1200 volt ampere and so on. So to convert a volt ampere into watts, you need to multiply volt into ampere will give you the volt ampere, which will be equivalent to watt in case of a DC supply. But in case of a AC supply, you need to multiply the power factor, which is 0.8. In case of inverters, the maximum power factor can be attained by a inverter is 0.8. So this is the global value. Power factor for inverters will be 0.8, and to convert the watt into volt ampere, you just multiply voltage into amperes. And the general efficiency of a battery, the battery which you are using in the inverter, is efficiency is 0.8. Let's move to an example. If you want to run a 200 watt of appliances, So what amount of inverter capacity you need and how much amount of backup time you can withstand. So you are going to connect one ceiling fan. The wattage of ceiling fan is 60 watt into one, which will give you 60 watts. Then you are going to connect two lamps. So two lamps is one lamp consumes 40 watts. So into two you will get 80 watts. Then you are going to connect a television. So 60 watts into one you will get 60 watts. Total you will be having 60 plus 80 plus 60 watts will be 200 watts. So you need to connect a load of 200 watt into the inverter. So let us find the backup time. So the backup time, the formula is battery ampere hour into battery voltage into number of batteries into efficiency of the battery divided by load in watts. So here the battery ampere hour is the ampere hour of your battery which you are using, and the battery voltage is normally 12 volt, and the number of batteries represent how much amount of batteries you are connected in parallel, not in series. Usually for inverters you will be connecting batteries in parallel, so it represents number of batteries connected in parallel into efficiency of the battery, which is nothing but 0.8, and the load in watts. This is the total load, which is the 200 watts you are going to connect in the inverter. So the net backup time you will be obtaining is, here you are assuming you are using a 60 ampere hour battery. So here the 60 is there, and the battery voltage is 12 volt, and the number of battery is 1, and the efficiency of the battery is 0.8, and the load in watts is 200 watt. So the backup time is 2.88 hours. So this is the backup time calculation for your inverter. Thank you.